EDSvideo.com. Thank you.
Alright, so let's summarize what we got here for the educational component of this thing. My patient here stepped on a needle, and the needle went in, and it's just a couple millimeters off the surface. It broke off. Family tried to get to it, but we can't. We already injected some medicine. That's why you see the little white area around it. That's the lidocaine, and kind of like causing a little vasoconstriction effect there. And we've let it go for a couple minutes, so it should be pretty numb. We're going to make sure it is numb. I'm going to cover the rest of the foot with this. So first we're going to make sure you're numb.
Be still.
You will feel pressure, but is it sharp pain at all?
No.
Good. So what we're going to do is make a cut so that
it's
we can actually explore the wound. Yeah. And I can already feel it there. Yeah, I think it's going to be an easy one, actually. The issue is that the skin gets on the way of grabbing it, so I do have a special kind of tissue openers.
Are you feeling it?
No, it was more of the pressure that shocked me. Right?
Mm. Ta-da!
Good.
What's that? I mean, really, the hard part was releasing the tissue, trying to minimize the amount of cutting around it. Otherwise, I would have made a big cut, done. But we minimized. I mean, can't even see the cut that I did. So nothing to repair.
We thought there were two pieces in there.
That's it.
You gonna keep that souvenir?
No, I'll get the other half at home.
You want it?
Sure, you can put it on the necklace.
My luck, I'll step on it.
So the important points about this is to try to get the foreign body out with doing the least trauma to the underlying tissue. As you can see, I was going really slow, trying to minimize the amount of scarring. Of course, it would have been easier to make one big cut, open it up, and get it out. But I was being very careful and detailed to do the least amount of cut so that the tissue would expose the foreign body and I could grab it. See, when the needle goes in, the tissue folds around it and covers it and doesn't allow you to just go in and grab it. So you had to dissect around it to expose it and pull it out. Secondly, the important thing is about tetanus immunization. Obviously, there's a foreign body penetrating, so the risk of infection or tetanus relatively low because it's not a tetanus-prone wound. This wasn't a rusty piece of metal or anything like that. Third, you know, penetrating like that is a puncture wound. You can't really irrigate it to clean it up. So it's a high risk of infection, so you put the patient on antibiotics prophylactically to prevent infection. If this was through the sole of a shoe, you have to think about pseudomonal coverage, so you would give fluoroquinolones like Cipro or some other kind of antibiotic like that. In this case, I just give the patient Keflex, pain medicine, and of course, warn the patient about the risk of infection, redness, swelling, discharge, any kind of fevers. She needs to come back for reassessment, follow-up, and maybe more aggressive treatment, because that penetration could have introduced bacteria deep into the tissue and caused infection. And lastly, a big shout out to the patient. Thank you so much for allowing us to record it. Thank you for being so good about the weight. The patient came in, it was a huge weight in our ER, and she was just a big trooper and very nice about it. And good thing is we got this taken care of for her with a fair amount of pain. You know, it's painful to go in and numb it. Of course, this part wasn't shown in the video when we put the numbing medicine on it. That part, it was the most painful. But after that, it wasn't painful at all. We were able to get it out, and hopefully she's recovering well. All right, thank you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Bye-bye.
EDSVideo.com. Thank you.